God's design for the human soul. Now to help you see and to help me make it clear how God has designed the human soul, I'm asking for your participation. Specifically, engage your imagination with me. This is Mary Alice with Life Lessons for the Heart, where our focus is living our spirit reality. Okay, now, are you ready? Let's get graphic. Picture with me an 18-wheeler. And for our purposes today, this vehicle is your soul. Please use the step and get in, for it is you that will manage its operation. Yes, your soul's operation. Okay, now we're in the cab, and you see that massive windshield through which you are going to view and assess every scene. That windshield represents your mind, the thoughts you generate from your view. Okay, grab that steering wheel. That's your will. For you see, for the human soul, the will is the master control, steering which way you choose to go. Now, securely hooked to the cab is that very elongated trailer, your emotions. Because you see, your emotions do follow your mind and your will. And if your emotions begin to sway to and fro wildly, jackknife, out of control, and over you go. Now we know that soul can calculate, enumerate, cogitate. Soul can choose, judge, and be moved by natural feelings. In a word, soul is self, sourced and tethered strictly to the natural realm. I think you can see how important it is with our walk with God that we distinguish soul from spirit. Generate and initiate our walk with God from soul. Never God's role, because it is not Holy Spirit indwelt. The natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God. However, and because your spirit now has a new source of life, soul's role is to be submissive, yielded to spirit, not initiating, but responding to spirit. Our soul does wait upon the Lord. That surely supports our learning to quiet our soul. Becoming sensitive to our inner man, our spirit, learning to go there. Perhaps we can sum up our new life as letting go and letting be. Letting go of self and letting be our spirit reality.